The history of basketball is rich with legendary performers. Those who have dominated the paint, dazzled us with their passing, displayed uncanny marksmanship, and risen above the crowd. Other than talent, the common thread among all these legends is simple. They're known by a single name. And now, as we look to the future, a young man called LeBron attempts to earn that same distinction. Can LeBron James take his first step toward legendary status? Find out next. There's one guy among us who has seen LeBron James play on several occasions. Jay Billis is here to give us some perspective. Jay, how good is LeBron James?
Well, simply put, Dan, LeBron James is the best high school basketball player I have ever seen. And I think as a 17-year-old, he's better than Kobe Bryant was at the same age. Why? Because he is just as skilled as Kobe Bryant was, but he is more physically imposing. At 6'7", 235 pounds, he is a man right now. And he's got an extraordinary skill level. He's also a brilliant passer, a guy that can play with other people, find teammates, and create shots for others. He's got a maturity level that most kids his age just don't have. And he will be, without a doubt, the first pick in the draft.
Side shot there is Swan, so the lead is still 7. This is the shooter, Corey Jones. There's James with a follow.
It's because they may come for academic reasons or competition.
Stolen by Brandon Williams.
Uh-oh. He's the truth.
In transition, finally an opportunity to show the elevation, the windmill, the creativity, the extension, the elevation.
How do you feel about all that?
Are you serious? Are you serious? Are you serious? How many college guys or NBA guys can make that pass in transition? In the NBA, that's a jam for a dunk. I mean, I got goosebumps watching that. That made me think of the Magic Man. Are you kidding?
Here comes James leading the Irish out. They were down big early, but there's another no-look feed.
That's what we're talking about, instincts, feel for the game. I mean, that is just so special, Bill.
The sense of where you are that we learned from Bill Bradley as a St. Louis high school phenom. LeBron James is moving right now at a different speed.
Led his high school to the state championship as a freshman, sophomore, got beat as a junior.
That's beautiful.
He's going in deep. Once he gets the ball in that deep, he's automatic.
This is what great players do. They take what they want.
They go to their strengths. Great vision all the time. Great vision.
The ball's an extension of his mind.
He knew he had that one, too.
Uh-oh, then it's chest pumping time. He's got it. I'll tell you right now, my friends, he's the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Would that make a lot of kids not come to college in the first place if you put that restriction in? James with certainly the ability to make it look like he can go to the next level.
Or off of him, make that choice for him.
And all those leeches, leave the kid alone. All those that want to sell t-shirts and bobblehead dolls and make money off them. Let him try to enjoy his senior year as much. He's got enough heat and pressure.
31 points standing by with Jay Billis. Jay?
LeBron, with all the hype going into this game, playing against the number one team on national television, did you feel a lot of pressure coming into this?
Well, you know, it's a different game, a different atmosphere today. And today, you know, we're playing the number one team in the country. And I don't think it was no pressure for our team. I think it was more pressure for the fans, you know, to come here. You know, we lost the last 2 years, and we just wanted to come here and get a victory.
You know, the cover of USA Today, the cover of ESPN Magazine last year on Sports Illustrated's cover. What do you think? Is this too much, or is it too much pressure for you?
Well, I think it's no pressure for me. I think if I come out and play my game and get my team involved in the game, you know, it's a lot of notoriety for me and my teammates, but I just go out, play my game every night and give it our all. And if we give it 110% like we did tonight, no, it's no pressure for us.
Your performance, you came out, it looked like you started slowly, relied a little bit too much on the jump shot. How did you calm yourself down?
Well, you know, at halftime, our team was telling me I need to go inside a little bit more because the player that was guarding me had 3 fouls at halftime. So I said, you know, anything it takes to win for our teammates. They told me to get inside, and I did that for our team, and we came out with a victory.
What's next for you? What do you have to improve upon when you want to take your game to the next level?
Well, you know, it's all about just getting better every day. You know, of course, you know, defensive-wise and getting your jump shot better to a perfection. But it's just getting better every day for our team and for myself.